Yes?
Well met, friend. What seems to be the problem? No need, friend. It just so happens I'm traveling there to visit my uncle. To be honest with you, I could use the company. No problem. Hop aboard, we'll be off.
Need something?
Well enough. Going somewhere? No chance. Way too dangerous. But I'll tell you what I'll do. I'll give you my old boat and directions to the jetty.
How's that sound? Easy. Just travel north. Once you see the island, keep going until you reach the northern tip. There's a jetty to moor the boat. Safe travels, friend.
Let's hear it.
Thank you.
死に損ないが。
死に損ないが。
お前なんか殺してやる。 Dragonborn! No. No. I think I'm fine. Yes. The guards shoved me into this room when the prison was attacked. Dragonborn, who the hell are these guys? What's going on? Okay. Great! Just great! Bravo, Dragonborn! Wait! Hello! Our only transport off this damn island has just disappeared into thin air. So I guess waiting is something we're going to be doing plenty of, unless you have another great idea. Or maybe, just maybe, a mud crab stowed away and cut the mooring rope with its claws. You did secure the boat, right? By the gods! I can't believe you lost the boat. Can't you do anything? Whatever. So what do we do now? Swim back to the mainland? Don't you go there, Dragonborn. I am not in the mood. So, what do we do now? So you want to hike all the way there in this crappy weather? We will freeze to death out there. You're kidding, right? No, never. Well, maybe once. Twice now, including the boat. I'm right behind you. Sure. They must have shipped my stuff here from the city. Just me and you against the whole world again, huh? What? You kidder. I wanted to ask you about Bobby. Sure. Is this the map? Hey! Looks like those places marked on it would give us shelter. Once we reach the forest, we can head for the village. Of course. Hey, I'm sorry I yelled at you back there. I didn't mean any of that. Dragonborn, I would follow you into hell itself if you so demanded it.
I'm as ready as I'll ever be. Dragonborn?
Okay, let's go.
Dragonborn, what is it? Thank you.
Sure.
Let's go.
taken anyone. Get us lost out here, or forget where I left the boat. Don't you yell at me, you yeller. I'm just cold, okay? Tired. Okay. Yeah, right.
Trap? How do you mean? I didn't get to see anyone. They pretty much took me straight to the dock. I told them we must wait for Carice, but they didn't listen. We saw the smoke from the distance. What happened?
Bobby? No! Dragonborn, say it's not true. Bastard. I can't believe it. Dragonborn, I don't think I want to hear anymore. Bobby is dead to me now. How did they trap you? Dragonborn, you're kidding. Minotaurs are extinct, right? How did you survive?
I knew you would come for me.
Don't you ever get tired of saving me? You must think I'm a real pain in the ass. What? Dragonborn, you kidder.
I wrote another poem while I waited for you.
Do you want to read it?
Okay. It's called Sand, Ice, and Blood. Bleeding is she, forgotten is he. Deeds long past. The gratitude of the people no longer lasts. Blood drips from the guilt, innocence paying the price of what the wrong built. Sick of the fighting, sick of the dying. Pain, our greatest teacher and enemy. Sands of time pass us by as we continue to die. What will you shape yourself into? What will you do? Tyrant or benevolent, the world you shape is by your hand. Through ice, we dice. Through sand, together we band. Through blood, tears and pain from those left. Blood.
If we ever get out of here, I will. One day. I'm going to call it Luna's Shadow, after someone who was very special to me, a long time ago. Good night, Dragonborn.
I was dreaming. No, nothing like that. We were looking at a strange mountain. It was, I don't know, kind of squarish. There were children playing. Many, many children. And a little girl left the others and came towards me. She pointed to the mountain.
Sure. After you. Let's go. You know, this is what it must be like on Atmora. It's the most northern land. Did you know that men originated from there? Well, that's what Freya thought told me. It wasn't always ice and snow. It used to have green fields. Then it went all cold. Ugh. You know, if we get caught out in the open by a storm, the best thing for us to do is dig a hole. Then, cut the blocks using the snow from the hole, and place them around a pellet, and then, get inside the hole and snuggle up. You know, keep each other warm with the body heat. Did you know, if you get frostbite on your fingers and toes, they can fall off? Not just those, but other dangly bits too. Hey! Back off, bucko! I'm just chillin', okay? Like, literally. We should be able to see better once we get over the rise. Whoa! We made it. The snow falls. Dragonborn, wait. Oh! Oh! Go. Here's the cave. Hey! Go get some wood and get the fire going. I need to thaw out. Choppity chop! Don't overdo it.
back straight.
Yeah, right.
Okay, okay. Keep your hair on. And don't you dare, Dragonborn. That bitch. First chance I get, I'm gonna ram my sword right up her ass. Ugh. Okay, okay. Yeah, right.
Dragonborn, over here. Quick.
Well, go on then. You go first. I hate caves. Go on then. Oh my days, Dragonborn, look! These are so wonderful. They must be so ancient. These are amazing. I've never seen anything like this before. Oh my! Giants! I heard tales of ice giants inhabiting these islands. Hope we don't run into any. How long do you think it'll take them to find out I'm gone? What will they do? Can they hold out? We never did work that out, did we? You know, being out here in the wilderness with you, I wouldn't trade it for anything. We are free here. For the first time since we left Bruma, I feel safe. I didn't think I was going to make it. I thought they were going to hurt me. But after she tore my dress almost completely off, she just left me there, crying. How do you know? No way! The bitch cut off all my hair and ripped my clothes, but I sat there and just let her. It's like,
It's like you have absolutely no control over your life or what's going to happen to you. And a numbness tries to protect you. I felt I was standing there beside her, looking on. I started to cry, but not because I felt sorry for myself. I was crying for her. The girl I used to be. The girl I was trying to be again. But fate wouldn't allow it. Destiny had not taken its course and still had your life in its hands, laughing at your suffering. I stood there in rags, my head shorn in that filthy cell. And the weird thing is, it was almost like home to me. I had been there before, and I had felt worse pain. There was nothing they could do to me. I just didn't care anymore. Like some ancient prophecy. What prophecy? That bitch? You can't be serious. Of course, Alicia, the mother of all Minotaurs. You mean Morag Cepheus is the chosen queen? Then that's it then. Cyrodiil is finished. We must stop her. Prophecy or no prophecy. Let war descend on Tamriel for another millennia, then she reign as queen. What? Dragonborn, what are we going to do? What will happen to us? Now we are alone again, just the two of us, together on a lost island in the sea of ghosts, sheltered from the storm in a world that doesn't care. Everything I've been through, I would do again, just to be here with you, for this moment. Maybe this is our moment. Yeah, you're right. Good night, Dragonborn. I'm just grabbing something to eat before we go. It's such a beautiful day, Dragonborn. Look. Sit down. Might as well make the most of it. Yeah, a huge minotaur was sitting on a throne. He must have been a king or a lord. And in one hand he held a mace, and the other a soul gem. Below, on the dais, a dragon was locked in an eternal battle with a serpent. It had huge horns, minotaur horns, but it was dark. But what else could it be? Hey, I wonder if Malisam found anything on Mirag Cepheus. Wasn't he going to Hammerfell? You never said, why would he volunteer to go? How would he even know? Yeah, he did, didn't I? I wonder if he still walks around in his underwear. Yeah, he stank. Yeah. Ooh. Wait here a moment. I need to pee.
Dragonborn, run!
the cave! Dragonborn, I'm sure this is Mr. Bear. Maybe he floated here on an iceberg. They do that sort of thing, you know. It is! It is, Mr. Bear! Mr. Bear, is that you? Yeah, I know. Cool, huh? You know, I felt something special just then, inside me. And right now, I have never, ever felt so happy in all my life. Me, you, and Mr. Bear. I think I'll write a poem about it someday. I can see the title now. The Dragon and the Bear. Yeah. Crazy. In a good way? Dragonborn, hold on. There's only one way down.
Come on, Dragonborn. Where's your sense of adventure?
The river flows east. We can follow it down, then turn off to the woodcutter's camp located on the map. Dragonborn, wait. You know, I haven't felt so happy since I was a kid. All this has brought it all back. I was wondering, what did you do? You know, when you were a kid. What do you mean you don't remember? There must be something that you keep with you from back then. Dragonborn. And? Wow, that really sucks. Well, maybe it'll come back to you. Like what happened with me. You just need something to jog your memory. You don't know that. I'm sorry. I wasn't trying to bring you down. Well, I have enough memories for two. I'm sorry. You don't want to hear some old, stuffy, crazy girl talk. Okay. You know our old house in Bruma? Well, it used to have a gate. My dad built a small fence and the gate was in two sections. He was really proud of that gate, and I must have been about 4 or 5. I used to swing on it. It was one of my first memories because it was getting late and I just stood still. Oh. I remember the sun was setting, and the yellowy orange top my mom had made. And I remember looking down at my feet, and I would wiggle my toes and swing my legs to make the gate swing to and fro. My mom would come out and tell me off, "Don't you break that! Get off before your father gets home!" My best friend at the time was a dog my friend.
in the shadows, and her dad was a stable man.